Welcome to MediPrep. I want to go over today basically a nice book that I think is important to have in the household. It's something that I use in practice as a nurse, and it's an invaluable resource for me when it comes to checking on the safe and appropriate administration, especially of IV medications. But obviously in the home, it does have use as well, and that is for oral dosing as well for certain medications that are taken by mouth. What this guide does is really breaks down kind of the relevant details about certain medications. It's a very small, very portable, practical, easy to use reference guide, kind of like a mini PDR. A PDR is a physician desk reference. This is a much smaller, not nearly as comprehensive or detailed a book as the PDR. I don't find the PDR practical for what I do. I find it to be far more comprehensive than is needed for the type of use that I have for a drug guide. And this definitely fits the bill. This is the Davis's drug guide. That's one particular author or publisher of this drug guide. There are many different drug guides that are geared for nursing. This is the one that I prefer and recommend. I just like the layout, the ease of use. I've never had a medication, I think with the exception of maybe one that I couldn't find in this. It's constantly updated. There are various versions. It's usually updated every year, if not 2 years. There's obviously the development of new medications all the time. But the common ones are definitely in there, the ones you're going to see on a regular basis. So the problem that I think a lot of people have is they have medications in their inventory, whether prescribed or over the counter, and maybe aren't as clear as to the safety of that medication, conflicts it may have with other medications, side effects that may be associated with that medication, and most importantly, adverse effects related to that medication, things you should be looking for if you're on that medication. Most medications are safe when prescribed, but there's always potential to have experience a side effect. Some medications are more associated with certain side effects than others, and some of these side effects are very benign. They really are not too concerning. They can be something as simple as nausea or headache, things like that. But other side effects can be quite serious. We call those adverse side effects. And they can be unique to that medication for some people, or they can happen when used in combination. When these medications are used in combination with other medications, there's a conflict between those two that can create a problem. So this book does a pretty good job as far as laying that out as well. Now, this isn't a one-stop kind of shopping when it comes to checking on those things. This is, for me, something I use in practice, but one of the other sources of information I use is my pharmacist. So without the guidance of a physician or a pharmacist, I think this is a good thing to use independent of that. If you don't have access to either, this is a good backup. But for all intents and purposes, you should be definitely contacting your physician or a pharmacist for a clear definition of any concerns you have, or the safe practice and administration of whatever medication you have on hand. Either of them can definitely help you out with that. But if you don't have access to either one, this is a really good resource to have. So these run, I think, anywhere about $40, $50, kind of in that neighborhood, brand new. You can definitely find them used online on Amazon or some other book sources, excuse me. Or even if you live near a university, especially one that has a nursing program, you're bound to find plenty of these in the used textbook store there, or rather the textbook store. You can find these used on the shelves there for much less than that. And just once again, I think it's a very valuable resource to have. Anyway, hopefully this was helpful, and I wish you all your best in your prepping.